Hey friends, it's your travel gal Allie, and today I am back with another one of my Chicago neighborhood guides. Today, we are exploring Wicker Park. We'll be checking out some of the neighborhood's most historic and architecturally significant homes, grabbing a bite to eat at a pub that mixes cuisine from two very different cultures, and stopping by a brand new spot to grab a drink. But before we get into my recommendations, I did just want to give you a little bit of history and some information that I think might be helpful to you before you visit Wicker Park. But if you're tight for time and you want to get right into my recommendations, then head to this timestamp right here.
And if you want even more recommendations on what to do in Wicker Park and in other neighborhoods in the city, just head to the link in the description to get your hands on my Chicago neighborhood guide. I've put all the spots in a handy Google map so that your planning process is super streamlined. Wicker Park is located just west of the Chicago River and about a 15-minute drive, depending on traffic, northwest of the Loop.
This artsy historic neighborhood is just a spot that has such a cool vibe that's almost really hard to describe. Ooh, and fun fact for you, Wicker Park is actually listed on the National Register of Historic Places. Speaking of history, the neighborhood was developed by the Wicker Brothers back in the 1870s. Now, the neighborhood experienced an unexpected boom following the Great Chicago Fire in 1871, when much of downtown was destroyed. By the 1900s, the neighborhood was mainly comprised of Polish, German, and Scandinavian communities who resided in some of these historic mansions that are still standing to this day.
Visit Wicker Park if you love trendy restaurants, historic homes, and wandering in a beautiful neighborhood.
One of the things Wicker Park is known for are these iconic mansions, once home to some of Chicago's most famous residents. In any neighborhood I explore, I always think it's important to start with some sort of a tour to really get a feel for the neighborhood and an understanding of its history.
Today, we're going on the Chicago Architecture Center's Beer Baron Row self-guided trail.
This tour was created specifically with Open House Chicago in mind, an annual event that features some of the city's most historically and architecturally significant sites across more than 20 of Chicago's neighborhoods.
This year's event has been reformatted to accommodate for social distancing. And Open House Chicago has created this super handy app with more than 50 programs and trails for you to explore at your own pace. Just head to the link in the description for more details.
This half a mile trail takes us along two streets, Hoyne and Pierce. Hey, that's me!
This cluster is home to some of the neighborhood's oldest and most beautiful homes. And it gets the name Beer Baron Row because of a two-block stretch of Hoyne that was favorited by Chicago's newly wealthy beer magnates back in the day.
All right, let's go check out some of these homes. We're gonna head to Pierce Street, and the first place that we're gonna stop at is a home that actually spans three city blocks. This is the kind of space that I need.
Built in 1884, this home was a private residence until 1930, when it became the Polish consulate.
Moving quite literally across the street, we are gonna go to the Weinhardt Mansion, which I like to call the gingerbread house, and you're gonna see why in a second.
Now this style is called a Queen Anne Victorian, cause she fancy, and she was built in 1888 and has been a private home ever since.
Now we're just gonna pop over to Hoyne Avenue. And fun fact, this was the first paved street in the city and people came from all over the place to roller skate and admire some of these beautiful homes.
Our next stop is one of the oldest homes in Wicker Park and has a pretty cool history. The home was built in 1877 for C. Herman Plotz, founder of the Chicago Drug and Chemical Company, who then went on to become the ambassador to Russia in the 1890s.
Get this, this is my favorite fact about this house. During Prohibition, they actually ran a speakeasy out of their basement. My kind of people. The next home on our tour is a lesson to all of us that sometimes when you got a really big home, you also got really big problems.
Built in 1886 by a German beer and wine merchant, this house was not the happiest of homes. The owner, John Rapp, was killed by his bookkeeper, his wife went insane, and his son was convicted of embezzlement.
Yikes. So if you can get past all the bad juju, this home actually was up for sale in 2018 for a cool $6.8 million, a record for the neighborhood. And if you're nosy and you want to see inside, I highly recommend looking it up on Zillow because it is incredible.
Our last stop takes us to the sandstone home, which just so happened to be the home of a dance and singing school before it was turned into a boarding school during the Great Depression. Now it's a single-family home. If only it were mine. Just a heads up, if you're not visiting around the time of Open House Chicago, not to worry. The Chicago Architecture Center offers tons of other walking tours across many of the city's neighborhoods. Friends, I had to pop a squat because my feet were kind of hurting me. But if you are enjoying this video, go ahead and hit that thumbs up. And if you have a favorite spot in Wicker Park, why don't you share with the class? Drop it in the comments and I will selfishly add it to my hit list because I'm always looking for some new places to explore. I'm assuming you've worked up an appetite by now, so I suggest grabbing a meal at The Perch, which is Wicker Park's brand new brew pub. Inside the restaurant is light and airy and even has its own on-site brewing facility, a partnership with Finch Beer Co. We're sitting outside because I'm trying to soak up the last bits of summer into fall weather, and we're in their beer garden, which is so funky and fun. Now, you need to come to this place if you love beer, fantastic food, and craft cocktails. It is seriously so amazing, and the menu is fantastic. After lunch, I'd suggest a stop at the neighborhood's namesake, Wicker Park. In 1870, when the Wicker brothers were building this neighborhood, they donated a 4-acre parcel of land to the city to be used as a park. And it's still a place to this day where people come, hang out, have a little picnic, if the weather is nice. Once you're done chilling in the park, head back towards the heart of Wicker Park. This is where you'll find the Flatiron Arts Building. Built in 1918 to be an office complex, it was converted in the 60s into an artist's community and is now home to art studios. And now I'm gonna end my day in my favorite way, with a drink and some delicious food. And for that, we're headed to Pub Royale. Go here if you're looking for inventive drinks, craft beer, and butter chicken. Thanks for traveling with me through Wicker Park. Now, if you want even more recommendations on what to eat, see, and do in Wicker Park and in other neighborhoods around the city, then you gotta check out my Chicago Neighborhood Guide. And don't forget to look into Open House Chicago. It's a free event, and it honestly is super cool, and I really think you guys should check it out. So I'm gonna put the link in the description for you guys to learn a little bit more about that free event that's coming up. Also, if you want to explore more of Chicago's neighborhoods, then I think you might like to check out my Chicago Neighborhood series. I'm gonna put a little preview of it right here and also in the link in the description. Now, you guys, if you wanna connect outside of YouTube, make sure that you're following me on Instagram. And for more travel videos just like this one, hit that subscribe button and the bell to get a notification when a new video goes live. But until that time, I'm gonna sign off and I'll catch you guys next time. See ya!